Friends, good morning. How are you? Hope that all of you are fine. We have finished 6 chapters and we are going to start new chapter number 7, and that is getting to know the plants. Students, this is very important and very interesting chapter also, because it is directly connected to our nature. So I hope that all of you give somewhat more interest in this chapter. And I want, in this chapter we are going to discuss, first of all we have to introduce this chapter basics, then after we'll discuss about herbs, it means the types of the plants, and we all know that basic 3 types of plants are there, because in our surrounding we can see so many different kind of plants. Some are having a short size, it means a very less size as compared to the trees. Some plants have a mediator size, it means moderate size, not so much having more height or so much less height. Okay, somewhat compared to our height only. Okay, and the trees which are having more heights. Okay. So basically 3 types of plants are there: herbs, shrubs, and third one is trees. And we all aware with the trees also. Mainly discuss about the herbs and shrubs and trees. Then after we will discuss about the stem, leaf, root, flower, because these are the nothing we can say that it is a parts of the plant. These are called parts of the plant. Parts meaning which is having different kinds of structure. Leaves, okay. Then after stem, root, that is the foundation. Okay. Due to roots, the whole plant can stand still. Okay. Trunk. So these are the parts of the plants. All plants have parts. Some plants doesn't get any kind of stems, only leaves are there. Some plants doesn't have flowers in it. So varieties of plants are there having different structure, but basic parts are these. Okay. Let us discuss about herbs, shrubs and trees. Herbs, shrubs and trees. In that, let us discuss first about herbs. What are herbs? Herbs are nothing but small plants having soft and delicate stem. These are soft and delicate stem. First of all, you have to understand the meaning of delicate. Delicate meaning was the thing which can bend easily, which can break easily by your hand simply. No any kind of extra machineries should be there. That is called delicate. Delicate stem meaning whatever, if you hold some kind of plant in your hand and if you could break easily, or if you can bend it easily, that is delicate. Okay. So herbs meaning what? It is having a delicate stem. Second thing, does not have a woody stem. Herbs do not have woody stem. Woody meaning hard wood. It does not have hard wood. Herbs have green and tender stem. Now another word came to know, that is tender stem. So tender meaning similar to the delicate also. Tender meaning that you can break easily. Okay. Also its color is green. Normally you can see the trunk color. Okay. We can say it is a brown color, but here herbs only have green colored stem and also thinner. Okay, it is thin enough that you can bend easily. You can easily bend the stem of the herb, like grass. You can see that wheat plant, if you have seen wheat plant, you can clearly observe that in that it can be bent easily, you can break easily. Herbs usually do not grow more than 1 meter in height. herbs usually do not grow more than 1 meter in height. Its height does not more than 1 meter. Lifespan only 1 year, maximum 1 year. Some plants only having a 1 month. Okay, so lifespan of herb is very much shorter. Okay, let us see some images. You can see over there that stems of herbs is delicate and soft, but they are strong enough to erect on their own. Yes, this is true. You can see wheat plant, its stem is very much delicate, but it can stand still onto the ground. Okay, you can see the grass, the crocon plant, you can see over here that these are herbs. Okay, let us see shrubs. Shrubs are medium sized plants with hard woody stem branching out near stem. It means what? The basic difference between herbs and shrubs is what? Shrubs having somewhat thicker stem, also the branches coming out of the stems from the ground, near to the ground. We can say that branching starts from bottom. Okay, some plants having branches only at the top side, but shrubs, okay, whatever the plants consider to be a shrub, its branches generally come out from bottom side also, from bottom to top. Whole plant is covered with the branches. Okay, and it is, second thing, it is having a woody stem. It means wood, particular woody, it means hard stem is there. And herb stem is green colored, but it is somewhat brown colored stem. Shrub tend to branch near ground level. Yes, this is what I am telling to you, that shrub tend to branch near ground level. Okay, so many branches are seen rising just above the ground. So many branches are seen rising just above the ground. It means whole plant is covered with the branches. Shrubs are bigger than herbs but smaller than trees. So we can say shrubs are considered to be a mediator. It means we can categorize as between herbs and trees. Lifespan of shrub is for many years, but it is less than that of trees. We all know that lifespan of the trees so many years, hundreds of years. Some trees are living for hundreds of years, but shrubs lifespan is somewhat for many years, but not as compared to the trees. The examples of shrubs is lemon tree, rose, tulsi, mehndi. Okay, so these are the examples of shrubs. Okay, you can see clearly in the image that two plants I have shown, that one is rose plant and second one is tulsi. You can see the stems, you can see clearly that stems over here also woody stem is there. Okay, and its height also, you have seen that height is more than 1 meter, and it can grow taller, 2 meter, 3 meter about. Okay, tulsi also, you can see woody stem. Okay, here branches are also was also there, but it will cut down. Okay, if you cut the branches from bottom, so its height will increase more and more. Many one of you have experience of this also. Let us discuss next category, that is trees. Trees are tall and big plants and with hard and woody stem, and we call it as a trunk, which usually gives out branches and leaves. Okay, as compared to the shrubs, the branching of the trees is not coming out from the bottom side, it is having branches from the generally on top side. The lifespan of the trees is very large. We can say, we cannot particularly say 6 years of lifespan. So many trees are living for thousands of years also. Okay. Neem, banyan, mango tree, palm tree, teak wood tree. So these are the best example of trees having more, which are giving more wood also. Here you can see the tree chart. It means so many kind of trees are given over here. Okay, so many kinds of trees are given. We can see one lemon tree. It means this is a lemon also considered to be a shrub, but here it is considered as a tree. So it is part of confusion. But according to the terms, according to the points, lemon is considered to be a shrub. All rest one are considered to be trees. Okay, so many trees are given. Okay, students, so if you want to refer more on this, you can refer to the given application, you can refer to the internet, it means ExtraMaths app, you can refer the app NCERT textbook and solution, you can refer to the website Diksha Government Team. Okay. We'll discuss next topics in next videos. Up to that, have a good day. Bye.